Today, I develop the story of the world cultural heritage, Yunglung and Gaolung royal tombs of the Joseon Dynasty. Yunglung and Gaolung are located at 24th Hyohaeng-ro, 481 Bungil-s, Hwaseong-si, Gyeonggi-do, Korea. Yunglung is a joint burial mound of the posthumous King Changjo, the father of King Jeongjo, the 32nd king of the Joseon Dynasty, and the Queen Hongyeong of the Hong Clan, while Gaolung is the joint burial mound of King Jeongjo, the 32nd king of Joseon, and the Queen Hyo-wi of the King Clan. The parking lot is divided into bus-only parking lot and public parking lot. There is a Korean cultural interpreter on site who provides commentary at 10 and 14 o'clock. Let's move to Yunglung. The entrance and ceremonial space of Yunglung include red arrogates, an obeisance stand, an incense pass, a king's pass, a caretaker's house, a tea-shaped shrine, and a stellar shed, but there is no royal kitchen. There are two monuments inside the stellar shed. One is a tombstone to the Joseon Dynasty erected during the Joseon Dynasty, and the other is a tombstone to the emperor erected during the Korean Empire. The burial mound omitted the railing stone and was surrounded only by retaining stones, and the side stone of retaining stones was special dignity to the order of King Jeongjo. It is unique in that the side stone is covered with a peony sprung the tomb of Jeongnung of King Injo, and the capstones of retaining walls are finely covered with lotus flowers. Stone civil official is unique that he is wearing a gold crown robe rather than the typical royal tomb style with a bokdu. One of the similarities in the special composition is the axis of the T-shaped shrine angle and the burial mound. In most royal tombs, the T-shaped shrine angle and the burial mound form a straight line, while the Yunglung does not form a straight line. It is said that the T-shaped shrine did not block the burial mound, so that the Crown Prince Sado would not be stopping. The axis of the burial mound was moved to east, raising concerns that the location of caretaker's house would block the southern view of the burial mound, and Jeongjo instructed the caretaker's house to stand side by side with the royal kitchen. Restored now is a caretaker's house, not a royal kitchen. To the left of Red Arrow Gate, there is a Gonshinji Pond, a circular pond in the shape of Yeowiju. It is said that this place was created according to the logic of Feng Shui, with a dragon that failed to ascend to sky holding Yeowiju in its mouth. Yeowiju is a symbol of dragon's wish-granting beak. Sunmyo, Yeongwon, Yeongnung is the only tomb that has all names of Myo-won-ling. In 1762, when Jeongjo passed away in an wooden light chest at the order of his father Yeongjo, a tomb was created on the Baebongsan Mountain in Dongdaemun-gu called Seoul. Afterwards, the tomb was named Su-un-myo, and when King Jeongjo ascended the throne in 1776, he was given the honorary title of Crown Prince Jang-un, and the tomb was upgraded to one and renamed Yeongwon. In 1789, the one was moved to its current location, Hasan, and was called Hyeolyung-won. When Empress Hongyeong Hong Clan passed away in 1815, a one was created with a joint burial at Hyeolyung-won in the following year, 1816. Afterwards, after the proclaiming of the Korean Empire, in 1899, Crown Prince Sado was honored. It was upgraded to a royal tomb and called Yunglung. Let's move to Jeongjo. Jeongjo, the son of Yeongjo and Yeongminri, was appointed Crown Prince the year after his birth, and took care of government affairs on behalf of Yeongjo from 1749. When he was 15 years old, however, due to a feud with his father Yeongjo, he became ill, and after repeated problems such as political confrontation with the Northern faction, he was dethroned from the position of Crown Prince in 1762 and passed away in an wooden dice chest. King Yongzhong restored his son's status as Crown Prince and gave him the posthumous title of Crown Prince Hado. After his son Chungzhong ascended the throne, he was given the title of Crown Prince Changhan. After the proclamation of the Korean Empire, he was honored as King Changzhong in 1899. And soon after, he was again honored as the Emperor and was given the title of Changzhou. When I think of Changzhou, I feel endless sorrow and heartbreak. No one was on Crown Prince Sado's side. Father, mother, stepmother, wife, and in-laws. They were all Northern factions, so they regarded all the Crown Princes who were close to the reformist Southern faction as enemies. Crown Prince Sado suffered from the severe mania, which was aggravated by King Yongzhong's inconsistent whims, extremely coercive education, and plotting by his Northern second wife, Queen Chungsun, and his wife's family. Furthermore, because Yongzhong could not allow Chungzhong to be the child of a criminal, he registered him as the adopted son of Crown Prince Hyojang, a descendant of the Jongbin Li clan, as King Yongzhong's eldest son. It was a cold-hearted act that killed Crown Prince Sado twice. Less Empress Hongyeong. Empress Hongyeong was the daughter of Yongpung Puwangun Hong Bonghan and was appointed Crown Princess in 1744. After her husband Crown Prince Sado passed away, she was appointed as Haebin, and when her son Chungzhong ascended the throne, she became Haegyeonggung. She also wrote Hanjungno, a memoir about her husband's death. She passed away at the age of 81 at the Changgyeonggung Palace in 1815. After the proclamation of the Korean Empire, she was reversed as Queen Hongyeong in 1899, and then as Empress soon after. We know her as the author of Hanjungno and as a woman of sorrow, but here is Hanjungno. The sorrow in Hanjungno is not a sorrow in Chinese characters, but a sorrow in the meaning of leisure. There are four volumes in total. The first volume was written in the year of her 60th birthday, and the remaining three volumes were written on a free day during the reign of her grandson Sunzhou, and mainly deal with defending her family. It is said that she wrote it hoping that her grandson would restore the honor of her family, which was not wrong, rather than the tragic death of her husband, who was so wrong. The sentences in Hanjungno are realistic and dynamic enough to be considered noble. And elegant writing style exudes the elegant elegance of a noble man of old and shows the beauty of honorifics. This work is said to be the highlight of Korean classical literature, as you can see typical examples of normative women in traditional society among the characters, including the author. Let's move to Yongbin Lee. Another woman, Lady Yongbin Lee, the mother of Crown Prince Sado, directly asked King Yongzhong to kill her child. He said that King Yongzhong was able to kill his child with less burden on his mind. Of course, there may have been an intention to give up the Crown Prince and instead protect her own safety and the Crown Prince. But was it because of a death of heart? She died just a few days after performing the last rites for Crown Prince Sado's 3 years of mourning. Thank you. Let's move to Kowloon. Kowloon is a joint burial mound of King Cheongjoo, the 22nd King of Joseon Dynasty, and Empress Hyoi Kim. The tomb is like a Yungnung, but the retained stones are omitted and the only the stone railings are surrounded. Using Hyalimwon system as a precedent, the royal kitchen and the caretaker's house were placed side by side in front of the west side of T-shaped shrine, but only the caretaker's house has been restored. The axis of mound, like Yungnung, is slanted to the east. Chunyanji Pond was built in the form of the general Bang Ji-won Do, unlike Yungnung's Gonji Pond, which is circular, but the viewing path is blocked. When King Cheongjoo passed away in 800, the tomb was built on the hill east of Hyalimwon for his father, Jangjo. However, after King Sunjo ascended the throne, there were rumors that Kowloon would be inauspicious, and in 1821, Empress Hyoi passed away. The relocation of Kowloon was decided on the hill west of Hyalimwon, and the tomb was created in the form of a joint burial mound. Let's move to King Cheongjoo. King Cheongjoo was the second son of posthumous King Jangjo and the Empress Hongyeong, and was born in Gyeongchunjeon Changgyeonggung Palace in 1752. He was installed as the Crown Prince in 1759, and in 1762, King Yeongjoo allowed him to be adopted by his first son Crown Prince Hyojang, who had died early, to give Cheongjoo a justification for succeeding to the throne. From 1775, he served as a proxy for King Yeongjoo. When Yeongjoo passed away in 1776, the following year, he ascended the throne and first worked to restore the honor of his father Jangjoo. He passed away at the age of 49 in Gyeongchunhon Changgyeonggung Palace. Instead of focusing on studies that emphasized theory, he developed the Silhak and brought about a literary revival in the late Joseon Dynasty. After the proclamation of the Korean Empire in 1899, he was revived as Emperor Jeongjoseon as a direct fifth generation ancestor of King Gojong. King Cheongjoo moved his father, Jangjo's Yeongwon, to his current location, Hyalimwon, built a new city in Suwon, and built a fortress wall. From 1790 to 1795, Gwacheon Temporary Palace, Anyang Temporary Palace, Sangcham Temporary Palace, Siung Temporary Palace, Ansan Temporary Palace, and Hwaseong Temporary Palace were installed at the important transit points. Among them, Hwaseong Temporary Palace can be said to be the most representative temporary palace in terms of size and function. We call the Temporary Palace Hangung Palace. Hwaseong Hangung Palace, along with the castle, is not just a simple architectural sculpture, but has great political and military significance as a symbol of the policy of strengthening royal power pursued by the reformative enlightened monarch Cheongjoo. After the relentless liquor prohibition of Yeongjoo, King Cheongjoo, who loved alcohol, ascended the throne, so how happy must be drinkers have been. He said that he filled a pencil case filled with alcohol and feed it to his subjects. His subjects, who were weak in drinking, often had to endure hardship, and it's said that he was a humane king who spoke bluntly well. Let's move to Empress Hyoi. Empress Hyoi, the ruler of Cheongpung Buwangun Kim Simu, whose family origin was Cheongpung, was appointed crown princess in 1762 and was appointed queen when King Cheongjoo ascended to the throne in 1776. He said that she was polite and gentle by nature and was praised for offering to Queen Cheongsun Kim and Empress Hongyeong Hong even after she was over 60 years old. When King Sunjo ascended to the throne, she became the Queen Dowager. She lived progress throughout her life and was offered an honorific title several times, but she refused them all, saying,
"It remains a pain in my heart that the previous king did not receive the honor. So how could it be appropriate for me as a widow to receive it?
She all refused, and it is said that in 1820, several ministers tried to hold a banquet for her, but she declined. She passed away at the age of 69 in Jagyeongjeon Hall of Changgyeonggung Palace in 1821. She was born with a poor health and lived an unstable life, and she was unable to bear children. However, not only was she extremely filial, but she was also respected and loved by many people for her innate virtue. But how could she feel it is on the inside? It said in annals that she even had an imaginary pregnancy due to the pressure of not being able to continue the royal lineage. There were several concubines who were officially selected to carry on the succession. There was even an incident in which Hong Gu-kyung, a major contributor to King Cheongjo's ascension to the throne, tried to poison Queen Hui when his younger sister Wonbin died, suspecting that she had killed Wonbin but failed. This is family tree of Changzhou and Cheongjo.